And here it is, we turn our attention to this 34th Psalm of David. This Psalm that David writes when he has fled from Saul and went to King Achish. And because King Achish recognized who he was, David became afraid for his life. So he acted as if he was mad to disguise his true identity. And God reaches in and delivers David out of his situation. I don't know about nobody else. That's why you can shout right there. Because I'm looking at a whole lot of folks God has delivered out of some situations. And he praises God throughout this psalm. And I encourage you, read the whole psalm, even in your devotional and meditative time this week. But I'm just going to deal with the first three verses. But he praises God for God delivering him out of a life-threatening situation. And then he starts it out with these familiar words: I will bless the Lord at all times. And see, I kind of changed the wording around and said, at all times, I will bless the Lord. See, that signifies that you got to have a level of growth and development to say, at all times, I will bless the Lord. Because the truth of the matter is, I don't necessarily want to pray bless the Lord at all times. Sometimes I want to get in my feelings. How many folks can come in and just tell the truth? And really, what we really have to do is drop a deeper anchor in what this I will bless really means. Because bless in the Hebrew is Barak. Yeah, Barack Obama, help me, Jesus. Barack Obama, George W. Bush, Jimmy Carter, somebody. Even some of the dead presidents. Lord have mercy, help them. But here, Barak means to kneel or to get down on one knee. And the implication here is that this whole I will bless is to pay homage to render service to yield oneself to. And here's what I want to suggest to you, that when we are in the middle of life, we have to commit ourselves to dwell in unconditional service and surrender. Oh, y'all hear me now. Dwell in unconditional service and surrender. That means we got to be willing to surrender our will over for the will of God. It means that we have to be willing to offer service for the good of humanity, even when we don't get something back in return. Because see, some of us, we only want to offer service as long as we get something back in return. Is there anybody in here who knows what it's like to do something for somebody, and then when you in need, those same people act like you ain't never done anything for them? Is there anybody who knows what it's like to bless somebody else, and then what you get back in return is the essence of ungratefulness? Anybody know what it's like to give your last dime to somebody, and then they turn around by their actions and spit in your face? Have you grown to the point where you can offer service for the good of humanity, whether you get some back or not, knowing that the payback that comes from God is the greater return that you really need in your life? Yeah, when you surrender to God, what you actually are saying, God, is I'm willing to put up my limited views of you, God, and I'm willing to allow you to be the God in my life that you say that you are. When you have this dwelling in unconditional service and surrender, here it is right here. Ain't nobody gonna shout, but it's the truth. You surrender your need to be right. Some of us will get nowhere because we just gotta be right. Sometimes you just gotta say, we're going to leave well enough alone. We're going to agree to disagree. And we're going to keep on moving. Because some of us have damaged very credible relationships and friendships just trying to be right. And saints of God, some of us in this surrender and service, we're going to have to look in the mirror. And we're going to have to tell ourselves the truth about ourselves. Oh, I know that ain't gonna shout you right there, but for some, we will not be set free until we look in the cameras of our life and do an interview with ourselves and tell ourselves the truth about ourselves. No, it ain't them. Stop talking and looking over there. Look back in the camera and tell yourself the truth about yourself. Because here's what I've discovered. When we tell the truth about ourselves, that's when God can get us the help that we need. I told him this morning, I didn't put his picture up in this illustration, but I was reading some on Grammy Award winner Kendrick Lamar. And Kendrick Lamar said that he had an opportunity to give an interview. And in that interview, he said he stopped hiding from what he was dealing with. He was dealing with depression, and he said that he had even been having suicidal thoughts. And he said as a result of confronting the truth of what he was dealing with, he was placed in a space where he could get some help that he needed, but he had to stop worrying about what everybody else had to say about his situation. Let me tell you something. Let me just talk real talk in here. Stop worrying about what folk got to say. They ain't paid your rent. They ain't paid your mortgage. They ain't put no food on your table. They ain't helped you get no gas. You better tell the truth, because when you tell the truth, you position yourself to get the help that God wants to send you.